I'm a fast bowler, or used to be, fairly fast. And of course, Sunil was a feisty, all for his size, 5'4", a feisty opening batsman. I mean, you know, he took him on. I did get him out once. I've had to remind him of that. And it's important, while Sunil was this amazing batsman, actually, he is quite a combative character. You have to be that sort of a player, to open the batting against all these, you know, Dennis Lilly, Jeff Thompsons, Andy Roberts, Malcolm Marshalls, Michael Holdings. You've got to have something in here. And Sunil has that, and we'll dig it out this evening. First question comes from Market Bosworth, which you wouldn't, it's a lovely town, Market Town, out here, Sonny. From Derek Jarom, he said, about 40 years ago, I saw the India touring side play Lancashire at Old Trafford. As a Lancashire member, he said, and India had a young opening batsman called Sunil Gavaskar. I thought he looked promising. But through my binoculars, I could see that he'd split his trousers. My question is, how can you bat if your trousers are split? Do you remember this?
I do remember this. So trying to play one of the shots, the trousers split over here, where the seam is, it just split. And this happened between lunch and tea. And I was changing the trouser and my captain, Ajit Wadekar, said, what do you think you're doing? He was sitting there. So I said, Captain, I'm changing the trousers. You know, the trousers stone, you saw that. He said, nothing doing. You're not going to change your luck. You're going to carry on in the same trousers. So I actually went out to bat wearing the same trousers, and Tony Greg was standing at Silly Point. And he turned around and said to me, I see you like air conditioning.
These mean fast bowlers, and come on, I mean, look at you. I mean, okay, I'll give you 5'5". I think it's 5'4", but I converted it on Google today. But anyway.
Actually, you know what? One of the things, if you ever meet Sachin Tendulkar, you've got to ask him who's taller.
I will remember next time.
Yeah. It's great fun.
Who is? You're going to say you are.
No, I'm not. But, you know, I keep telling him that, you know, because he's got more hair and his hair is bigger than me.
Okay. That could be a reason. You know. But how? How do someone of that... I mean, is it easier for someone of that stature to play against these great big fast bowlers? I don't know. It just seems sort of unfair in a way. These great towering giants of the West Indies that you were doing battle with. How did you do it? How did you learn how to play that?
Well, with your eyes closed, it's easy.
that was my game.
No, I think, yes, there is a certain advantage if you're short stature, because a lot of the bouncers which give problems for somebody who's, say, 6 feet would sail over the short batsman's head. And you've got to be really, really expressed to be able to get the ball to get up off a length. And the one that would really trouble the short batsman is the one that climbs off a length. Now, only the quickest bowlers like a Jeff Thompson or a Michael Holding would be able to get that. Yes. Or maybe the others also did, but that was occasional. With Tomo and Mikey, they did it regularly. So you really had to be on guard against them, with not so much with the short ball, but the short of a good length delivery. But basically, I think the big advantage always...
That helmet you're wearing there, I must mention that, it's just come up. I mean, that was... That came later, I guess, did it?
That came later. I actually got it made in Nottingham. The only thing was, I wanted something which was light. So I said, can you cut off the top?
Oh, yes.
So, which would take a fair bit of the weight off.
Yeah.
Because, look, I mean, Jonathan, come on. I mean, you've got to be an absolute idiot to, you know, go like this and get hit here. You get hit here when you try to play the...
Guess where Curtly Ambrose hit me?
Here?
There. Ah.
It was a new experience. I wasn't very sure at the start, but Aggers has got this wonderful ability to relax even while he's asking hard questions to make you relax, and that's what he did. He sort of helped me to relax a lot, even as he probed about my career, about certain incidents in my life. I enjoyed myself, and I certainly hope those who came to watch it enjoyed themselves too.
Well, it's fantastic. I mean, we've had Jeffrey here before, Jeffrey Boycott in January. So Jonathan and I have done these shows with him and with Swanee in Nottingham, which was great fun. But no, it's a real thrill, actually. I mean, he's great. It was, you know, he's one of my heroes, certainly, growing up watching him play. I watched him play at the Oval at Lord's. So really, really nice to meet him. A lovely man and some great stories. And it was a really, really good evening. Really enjoyable.
Not pretend to be. I know, I'm not pretending. I thought it was really good. Really enjoyed it.
John Agnew is a very old friend. And I was looking forward to seeing him converse with Sunil Gavaskar, who's perhaps the most brilliant cricketer that his country's ever produced. And I know that they're good friends, and I expected this evening to be great fun, as it was great fun.
I thought it was very good. We came last year to see Jeff Boycott and Aggers, and we enjoyed that, so we knew what we were going to get. And we enjoyed listening to his background, and we knew more about him than we did before.